At the 2016 Skoll World Forum in Oxford, I was thunderstruck by a young woman from Afghanistan who had transformed her experience of child marriage in her own community into art, a rap song and an accompanying video, which has now been seen over a million times. The clarity of her message and the fierceness of her delivery is carrying her message around the world, and we're thrilled that she's here performing Daughters for Sale. This is Sonita Alizadeh.
فریاد به جای سکوت یک زن، فریاد به جای عمق زخمای ای تن، فریاد در جسمی که تقف از خسته شد، زیر فشار قیمت ها شما شکسته شد. به 15 سال منه از شهر هراتون، چند نفر آمادن خسته گریم گیجوماتون گیجوماتون از ای آدم ها و رسم ازدواج و خر با پول میفروشن بدون حق انتخاب. حال بس پدم خارج آمنونه، هرکی پول بیشتر بده دختر مال اونه. اگه میفهمیدم به خارج به کتاب میکنی، مگه میفهمیدم لقمه ها به حساب میکنی، با شکم گروز نه سفره بر میگشم، یا که تموند غذا هار بر میشم و مثل کل دخترت بندیم از چشم خاله واده گردریم. حالا ایشکی نمیتون جواب بده. بذاریم داد بزنم از سکوت خسته شدم، فساخو برداریم که حرف بزنم خفه شدم. اون قنده با من حرف نزدیم که من هر لحظه بزبورم دست رو خوچه کنم که قابل لمسه. انگار صدا ندارم وجود نپر شکه، اگه زنده نیم چهره ردش لاغ و حکم. میفهمم رسم شهر شما که دختر ساکت چه، بگیم چه کار کنم تا وجود مثابت شه. شاید فرار یا خودکشی از سه موقته، آدم چاره ای نداره وقتی بی حمایته. اما تار مو آمرم که کنده باشیم، ای کار نمی کنم که صرف کنده باشیم. اگه فروش می برش ما جای خوشحالیه، سعی می کنم دروغ بگم همه چی عالیه، مکه از خدا من لبخند باشه بله باشه ما. Thanks.
I wanted to say a quick hello to all of us, all of you watching us live on the intertubes. It's great to have you with us. Sonita, thank you so much for being here and for your powerful song. Would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I was born in Afghanistan, but my family fled the Taliban, so I grew up mostly as a refugee in Iran. Child marriage is a tradition, and my mom was married herself at age 12 or 13. So it was all that she knew. And when I realized that my family was discussing about selling me, I became so depressed. I had dreams, hope for my future. And I knew that if I had to get married, all those dreams would die. So I started expressing myself and my feelings by writing lyrics, music, and music, rap music, gave me a space to share stories. With the help of some friends, I made a music video called Daughter for Sale. it went viral, and then I got a scholarship. I came to the U.S. for the first time in my life. I'm in a real school, and I am an advocate to end child marriage, and I'm really happy to be here to talk about child marriage because it really impacts health.
So we know that we know that complications in pregnancy and childbirth is a leading cause of death for girls aged 15 to 19. We know that in developing countries, the vast majority of those pregnancies are among girls who are already married. I know you read the new World Bank report, which lays out that we could prevent the deaths of 2.1 million children and the stunting of 3.6 million more by 2030 if we eliminated child marriage. It's clear that child marriage is a significant public health concern. I wondered if you could talk about the impact you've seen on the individual health of girls forced into marriage.
Yes, of course. We can prevent many millions of babies from dying just by ending child marriage. Child marriage forces girls to have sex while their bodies are not developed enough to have babies. One of my friends, she was 12 years old when she got married, and she became pregnant with twins when she was 13 years old. So family didn't allow her to go to a hospital. So a woman from the neighborhood, she delivered her baby. My friend was bleeding severely. Finally, the family allowed her to go to the hospital. She survived, but after her childbirth, she couldn't properly walk for 2 years. And then at that condition, she was expected to do cleaning, cooking for the family. It is a story of millions of girls underage marriage.
Yeah, and mental health must be a concern as well.
Of course. So let me tell you another story. One of my friends, she was 11 years old when she got married. And on the day of her marriage, she disappeared. We were looking everywhere for her, but we couldn't find her. And the father was concerned about his honor. Finally, at the end of the day, her mom found her under their bed. She was hiding the whole day there just to not get married. When they sent her to her husband's house, she didn't want to have sex. And because of that, her husband slapped her. The next day, we saw blood on the wall, and her face was bruised. So most of the child marriages lead to rape, domestic violence, and depression.
I think we have time for one more question. Sonita, do you consider yourself an artist or an activist first?
What do you think? Both. So I am an activist first. I write about what I think is important. Music is really powerful. It's a tool to share messages, to share stories with people, and to raise awareness about a problem that doesn't have a face. So I wrote about things that I care the most, like women's rights. And I'm sure that with music, we can bring a change. And I believe that we can have a safer place, a better world for all of us by using however we can help. Look, or whatever talent we have.
Yeah. Sonia, I know you're a senior now and thinking about schools. There are a lot of terrific universities in this country. I'm partial to one on the East Coast, but I can think of one school that would be really lucky to have you. So thank you for coming and joining us today.
Thank you.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you. Sonia.